Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss stability analysis of gravity retaining wall from the chapter Earth Pressure Theory. Check the stability of the gravity retaining wall shown in figure. Take allowable soil pressure equal to 600 kN per meter cube. Use Coulomb's theory. So let us first see the dimensions of the retaining wall. The top width of the retaining wall is 0.5 meter. The overall height of the retaining wall is 5.7 meter. The height of the retaining wall above ground level is 4.5 meter. And the base slab is laid at a depth of 0.5 meter from the ground surface. The total thickness of the base slab is or foundation is 0.7 meter. The back of the retaining wall is inclined at an angle beta equal to 70 degree. And the distance of the retaining wall from the toe is 0.4 meter. Similarly, distance of the back of the wall from the heel is 0.5 meter. Now the vertical surface of the retaining wall towards the toe is inclined. So this horizontal distance covered by this inclined surface is 0.19 meter. Also, back of the retaining wall is also inclined at an angle 70 degree. So the horizontal distance covered by this inclined height is 1.71 meter. Now, active pressure PA is acting at the back of retaining wall at a point which is 1.2 meter above the foundation. This PA is inclined at an angle 24 degree to the normal. So this line is the normal to the surface of the retaining wall, and this normal is inclined at an angle 20 degree with the horizontal. So angle between PA and normal is 24 degree. The total base width of the retaining wall is 3.2 meter. Now let us start with the solution. Means let us start with the stability checks of the retaining wall. So here active pressure PA is obtained from the formula PA is equal to half KA gamma H square. So here we are supposed to use Coulomb's theory. So as per Coulomb's theory, the value of KA is obtained as KA equal to sin square beta plus phi dash divided by sin square beta into sin beta minus delta into bracket 1 plus under root of sin phi dash plus delta into sin phi dash minus I upon sin beta minus delta into sin beta plus I bracket complete and square of the bracket. So here beta is the angle made by the back of the retaining wall with the horizontal, which is 70 degree. So beta is equal to 70 degree. Phi dash is the angle of internal friction. So let us assume phi dash is equal to 36 degree. Now angle delta is the angle between active pressure and the normal to the retaining wall. So this angle is 24 degree. So delta becomes equal to 24 degree. And I is the surcharge angle, that means angle made by the surface of the backfill with horizontal. So it is 0 because backfill is horizontal. So now putting this value in this equation, we will get KA equal to sin square 70 plus 36 divided by sin square 70 into sin 70 minus 24 inside the bracket 1 plus under root of sin 36 plus 24 into sin 36 minus 0 upon sin 70 minus 24 into sin 70 plus 0 and square of this bracket. So here sin square 70 plus 36 becomes equal to 0.924. Sin square 70 becomes equal to 0.883. Sin 70 minus 24 is equal to 0.719. And sin 36 plus 24 is 0.866. Sin 36 is 0.588. Sin 70 minus 24 is 0.719. And sin 70 plus 0 is 0.940. So this is square of this bracket. So value of Ka becomes equal to 0.417. Now putting this value of Ka in the first equation, which is Pa equal to half Ka gamma h square, we will get value of active earth pressure. So it is equal to half into Ka as 0.417 into 19 as gamma and H is 5.7. So this is 5.7 square. So Pa becomes equal to 128.7 kilonewton. So value of Pa is 128.7 kilonewton. So horizontal component of Pa will be equal to pH, which is equal to Pa cos 20 plus 24. So pH will be equal to 92.6. And vertical component of Pa will be equal to PV. So this is PV, which is equal to Pa sin 20 plus 24. So PV will be equal to 89.4 kilonewton. So the value of Pa, which is active pressure acting on the wall, is 128.7. So the horizontal component of Pa is pH equal to 92.6 and the vertical component of Pa is PV equal to 89.4. The another force acting on this retaining wall is the self weight of this retaining wall. So in order to calculate the weight of the retaining wall, we have divided the area of the retaining wall into four parts. The first part is this triangular portion. So this triangular portion is numbered as area 1. The second part is this rectangular middle portion. So this portion is numbered as area 2. The third portion is this portion towards the backfill, this triangular portion towards the backfill, and it is numbered as portion 3. And the last part is the portion of this foundation or portion at the base. It is numbered as number 4. So weight of the area 1 is W1. The weight of the area 2 is W2. The weight of area 3 is W3. And weight of the area 4 is W4. So now let us list out the different forces acting on this retaining wall and movements caused due to these forces in tabular format. So here weight W1 is equal to area of this first triangular portion, which is equal to half into height into base into density. So here height is 5 meter because overall height of the retaining wall is 5.7 meter and the height of slab is 0.7 meter. So the net height of this triangular portion will be equal to 5 meter. The width of the base is 0.19 meter. And the density of this concrete retaining wall is assumed as 24 kilonewton per meter cube. So density is 24. So weight W1 becomes equal to 11.4. It is acting in vertical direction. So here, lever arm is the distance of CG of the first portion from the toe of the retaining wall. So lever arm will be equal to 0.4 plus 2/3 of the 0.19. So lever arm will be equal to 0.53. So the movement of this area about toe is equal to 11.4 into 0.53, which is equal to 6. And this movement is taking place in clockwise direction. So this movement 6 is in clockwise direction. Now weight W2 is the weight of the second area. It is equal to base into height into density. So base is the 0.5 meter, height is 5 meter and density is 24. So weight becomes equal to 60 kilonewton and it is acting in obviously vertically downward direction. Lever arm is the distance of CG of this area from toe. So it is equal to 0.4 plus 0.19 plus half of 0.5. So this lever arm becomes equal to 0.84. And the movement due to this portion toe is in clockwise direction. This movement is equal to force into lever arm, which is equal to 60 into 0.84, that is 50.4. Now here, weight W3 is the weight of the third portion. The third portion is triangular, that's why its area will be half into base into height. So base is 1.71 meter, height is 5 meter and density is 24. So weight W3 becomes equal to half into 5 into 1.71 into 24. So W3 is equal to 102.6. It is obviously acting in downward direction because it is weight. Lever arm is equal to distance of CG of this triangular portion from the toe. So it is equal to 0.4 plus 0.19 plus 0.5 plus 1/3 of 1.71. So lever arm becomes equal to 1.66 and the movement is equal to force into lever arm. It is equal to 170.3. This movement is also acting in clockwise direction about toe point. Now weight W4 is the weight of the fourth portion, which is equal to area into density. So area is 3.2 into height 0.7 and density is 24. So total weight is equal to 53.8. Lever arm is equal to half of the base width, means 3.2 divided by 2. So lever arm is 1.6. So the movement of this area about toe is equal to force into lever arm, which is 53.8 into 1.6. So movement is equal to 86.1. This movement is also taking place in clockwise direction. The next force acting on this retaining wall is the vertical component of active earth pressure. It is denoted as PV. So this PV is, we have already calculated its value. It is 89.4. Obviously, it is acting in vertical direction. And lever arm for this force is equal to 0.4 plus 0.19 plus 0.5 plus 1.71 minus this distance, which is equal to 1.2 upon 1070. So this lever arm becomes equal to 2.39 and the movement is obviously taking place in clockwise direction about toe point. So the total moment will be the force into distance. It is equal to 89.4 into 2.39. So moment is equal to 213.6. Now next force acting on the retaining wall is horizontal component of active earth pressure denoted as PH. So obviously it is acting in horizontal direction and we have already calculated its value. It is 92.6 and lever arm for this force is 1.2 plus 0.7. So it is 1.9. This is the vertical distance between toe and PH. So the total moment will be the force into distance. So this moment will take place in now anti-clockwise direction and it is equal to 92.6 into 1.9. So moment is equal to 175.9. So from this diagram we can say that the total vertical force acting is summation of all these forces. It is equal to 317.2. Total horizontal force acting is 92.6 and total clockwise movement is equal to summation of these movements, which is equal to 526.4, and total anti-clockwise movement is equal to 175.9. So the total movement about toe point is equal to summation of clockwise movement minus summation of anti-clockwise movement. So net movement is equal to 526.4 minus 175.9. So net movement is equal to 350.5 kilonewton meter. Now from the table we have obtained the total forces in vertical direction is equal to 317.2. Total forces in horizontal direction is equal to 92.6 kilonewton. The clockwise movement, total clockwise movement is equal to 526.4 kilonewton meter. The total anti-clockwise movement is equal to 175.9 and net movement is equal to clockwise minus anti-clockwise movement. It is equal to 350.5. So the first factor of safety, which is factor of safety against sliding, is given by Fs is equal to mu into Rv divided by Rh. So here mu is the coefficient of friction between wall and the soil and its value is equal to tan delta, where delta is the angle between PA and the normal to the back of the wall, which is 24 degrees. So mu is equal to tan 24. Rv is the summation of vertical forces. It is equal to 317.2. And Rh is the summation of horizontal forces, which is equal to 92.6. So factor of safety against sliding is obtained as 1.53. So factor of safety against sliding should be at least 1.5. So obtained factor of safety is greater than 1.5. That's why retaining wall is safe against sliding. Now the next factor of safety is factor of safety against overturning. Now suppose this is the retaining wall under consideration and this is the toe of the retaining wall. So all the clockwise movement resist the overturning of the retaining wall. So this clockwise movements are the resisting movement and all the anti-clockwise movement about toe try to cause overturning. So this anti-clockwise movements are the overturning moment. So, factor of safety against overturning is given by FO equal to summation of MR, which is resisting moments, divided by summation of MO. These are overturning moments. So, all the clockwise moments are the resisting moments. So, clockwise moments is 526.4. And overturning moments are the anti-clockwise moments. So, which is equal to 175.9. So, factor of safety against overturning is 2.99. Generally, the factor of safety against overturning should be within 1.5 to 2. So, here factor of safety obtained is greater than 2. That's why retaining wall is safe against overturning. Now, X bar is the distance where resultant all the vertical and horizontal forces strike the base of the retaining wall. So, this distance is the X bar. So, X bar is obtained as summation of M divided by summation of V. So, summation of M is the net moment, which is clockwise moments minus anti-clockwise moment. It is equal to 350.5. And summation of V is the summation of vertical forces, which is equal to 317.2. So, X bar obtained is equal to 1.1 meter. So, using this value, we will find the eccentricity. So, eccentricity is the distance between the point where this resultant strike the base of the slab and midpoint of the slab. So, eccentricity E will be equal to B by 2 minus X bar, which is equal to 1.6 minus 1.1 equal to 0.5 meter. Now, the total base width of the retaining wall B is 3.2 meter. So, B by 6 becomes equal to 0.533. Value of E is 0.5 and B by 6 is 0.533. That means value of E is less than B by 6. Hence, as value of E is less than B by 6, there is no tension. Now, using this value of E, we can determine the value of P max and P min. So, P max is the maximum pressure at the base. It is equal to summation of V by B into 1 plus 6 E by B, which is equal to 317.2 divided by 3.2 into 1 plus 6 into 0.5 divided by 3.2. So, Pmax becomes equal to 192 kilonewton per meter square. Similarly, Pmin is the minimum pressure at the base of the retaining wall. It is equal to summation of V by B into 1 minus 6E divided by B. So, Pmin becomes equal to 317.2 divided by 3.2 into 1 minus 6 into 0.5 divided by 3.2. So, value of P min is equal to 6.2 kilonewton per meter square. That means there is no tension developed at the base of the retaining wall. Hence, wall is safe against tension. Also, the factor of safety against bearing failure is given by FB equal to QNA divided by PMAX. QNA is the maximum allowable bearing pressure. It is already given as 600 and PMAX obtained is 192. So, FB becomes equal to 600 divided by 192. It is equal to 3.91. The minimum factor of safety against bearing should be 3. So, here value of FB obtained is 3.91, which is greater than 3. Hence, the retaining wall is safe against bearing failure. Thank you for watching.